it's important to be able to reason about this the way that I just described to you, right? So we sort of walked our way through. We figured out what kind of bandwidth we were getting and what percentage of theoretical peak that was. We saw that it was really quite low. And we said, why would we be getting low bandwidth to global memory? Well, the first thing you always look at there is coalescing. And then we inspected the code and convinced ourselves that yes, there's bad coalescing happening when we write to the output matrix. But I also want to make the point that you don't have to do this from scratch every time, right? Doing all these calculations is a little bit like rubbing two sticks together to start a fire. It's good to know how, but there are tools to help you do this. The tool that we're going to be using is called Insight. This is an NVIDIA product. There's also third-party products. Maybe I'll give some links to those in the supplementary material. And if you're using Linux or a Mac like I'm using, then you'll be using the Insight Eclipse Edition. If you were using Windows, you'd be using Insight Visual Studio Edition. These are integrated debuggers and profilers. They're full-blown development environments. The part that we're going to use is called the NVIDIA Visual Profiler, or NVPP. Let's fire that up now.